I'm Christian Schaefer with your WMAR 2 News update today. The former mayor of Baltimore City, Catherine Pugh, will find out how much time she'll have to spend in federal prison. In a surprise move last night, Pugh's attorney released a highly produced 13-minute video in which the former mayor apologizes to the citizens of Baltimore. It's the first time in nearly a year that Catherine Pugh has spoken publicly about anything. She says she's sorry, but she does not say why she would have participated in a scheme involving those Healthy Holly books. Here's a small portion of that video.
First, I just want to apologize to the citizens, to young people, to my partners, my friends, everyone I've offended, everyone I've hurt, and the city's image. When I think about me and my capacity and my capabilities and all the things I've been able to do, I said, how do you end up here? I mean, how do you mess this up? I messed up.
So just to be clear, we did not edit the video that way. It was sent to us with her face and her voice being edited onto it along with that music. But that's a key question. Catherine Pugh in the video seems to be asking herself. She does not answer it. You can watch the entire 13-minute video on the website, WMAR2news.com. Baltimore City Police are looking for a person who stabbed and killed a 76-year-old man inside of his apartment. On Tuesday, police officers found Richard Diggs dead inside the Coleman Manor Senior Living Apartments. This is in the Mondawmin neighborhood, a few blocks south of Mondawmin Mall. Friends say they're frustrated by what they say is a lack of security in that building. Too easy for people to follow some other person in through the front door. Police have not released any information about a possible suspect. Baltimore City wants to install speed cameras on the JFX. The city's Department of Transportation says speed cameras around the city have decreased crashes by more than 20% over the last 2 years of the program. I-83 in Baltimore is a marked interstate highway, but it's maintained by the city's Department of Transportation. The director says there's about twice as many crashes on the JFX as there are on other interstates in Maryland. To allow speed cameras to be installed on the JFX would require a change in state law. City officials have not pinpointed a spot for those cameras, but they could be movable and change their locations every 3 to 6 months. There's a hearing in the state Senate today.
And now from WMAR 2 News, Maryland's most accurate forecast.
Happy Thursday, everyone. On this Thursday, we're tracking the wind and the cold. Woo, it's rough out there for today. Warmer temperatures are on the way. You're going to want to stick around for that. And then the rain will move back in as we head into next week. So let's talk about the wind, because the wind has been around all day long. It's going to continue with that even as we go into the evening, and also tomorrow it won't be as windy. But for today, those gust up to about 40 to 45 miles an hour. So windy, in fact, that even as I'm forecasting a high today right around 42, by the afternoon, evening time frame, it is going to still feel like the 20s. So that's what you need to dress for this morning, this afternoon, this evening. Dress for these numbers staying or feeling like they are in the 20s. Lots of sunshine in the forecast for today. Hopefully you can get out there and enjoy it. Just dress accordingly. As we head towards Friday, 46 degrees, lots of sunshine, staying on the dry side right into the weekend, Christian, but it will be cold on Saturday. But then check out the 60s as we head into Monday with some showers in the forecast.
Looking more like spring there. Lynette, thanks very much. Programming note tonight, right here on WMAR. You can join us for a special Black History Month celebration. Starts at 7 o'clock tonight. Mallory Safaste and Patrick Pete starting it off, highlighting people who make positive impacts in our communities, using their lives and experiences to bridge the gap. And then at 7:30, Kelly Swoop's going to highlight how Black Greek life is also bridging the gap. So all that starts on WMAR 2 News at 7 o'clock tonight. That's all the time we have for now, but stick with us online at WMAR2news.com all day long for updates on top stories and breaking news, including the sentencing of the former mayor, Catherine Pugh. And for news and weather on the go, you can download the WMAR 2 News app from the App Store. It's got live radar, and you can set up breaking news alerts to come straight to your phone or tablet. Thanks for watching. I'm Christian Schaefer.
This WMAR 2 News update is sponsored by Jones Junction.